Up next, we look at updates to Microsoft Power BI that make it even easier for anyone to find and use it through native installation with the Microsoft 365 apps, as well as new experiences that light up, such as direct report sharing, whether you're in OneDrive or SharePoint. We'll also demonstrate the new multiple audiences capability for internal users to share insights to specific people within their organization, all from a single workspace, and the new cross-tenant dataset sharing capabilities that greatly simplifies external sharing and collaboration with people outside your organization. And to walk us through all of these updates, I'm joined by Mohammad Ali from the Microsoft Power BI team. Mohammad, welcome to Mechanics.
Thanks so much, Ben. It's a great pleasure to be here.
So from our last deep dive on Power BI, we really focused on the AI-driven insights as well as integration with Microsoft's analytics stack. Now, if you missed that show, you can watch it at aka.ms/Power BI AI Mechanics. Now, one of the things we highlighted at the time was the work being done to make Power BI capabilities more discoverable through the apps that you use every day. We showed the integration between Microsoft Teams and the new Power BI app. And with these latest updates, it really takes things to a next level.
Yes, Ben, they really do. So not only are we making it easier to collaborate on reports and datasets as you work in your favorite Microsoft 365 apps, but it's now a lot easier to share and work together on reports inside your organization. And it's easier than ever to share datasets and reports securely outside your organization, also while using any device with your data.
And it really is a natural evolution. And it's great to see that Power BI is now natively included and can be installed with the Microsoft 365 apps, which means it can also be deployed by IT right alongside Word, Excel, Outlook, Teams, and more.
Right, it makes things a lot easier for IT to deploy Power BI to everyone in the organization and also keep it up to date. And this signals an even deeper integration with Microsoft 365 experiences as you work. Most recently in areas like native integration with PowerPoint, where you can embed live, fully interactive Power BI reports directly into your presentation and interact with the visuals and slice and dice as you present to others. Or as you author emails, being able to find and add Power BI content directly into your Outlook emails as interactive adaptive cards. And this level of integration is designed to complement the way you typically work, so much so that we're also bringing experiences you may be used to in Microsoft 365 directly inside Power BI. So for example, a lot of Excel users rely heavily on contextual on-object controls. These are designed to help you edit objects such as text and visuals quickly so you don't have to search for these controls. They're just there front and center as part of your authoring experience. For example, I'll click on this chart, and by clicking on the plus sign, I can easily add chart elements like axes and chart title really quickly. So now we're bringing the same type of on-object controls directly to Power BI. So back in Power BI, you'll see I have almost the exact same visual. You'll see the on-object controls, and just like I did in Excel, I'll add the title and both axes in Power BI as well. And look how much easier this is and how much this speeds up the authoring process for me.
Which is really useful and helps keep things familiar as you're moving from Excel to Power BI. Now, you mentioned improving the internal sharing capabilities. Does this mean better support for OneDrive and SharePoint?
Yes, absolutely. So one of the big things we're doing is to make it so that you can preview and interact with Power BI report files directly inside OneDrive and SharePoint, and even share them with others. Let me give you an early look at this experience. So the first thing I'm going to show you is how I can share the report that I just authored using OneDrive. And I can now do this all natively inside Power BI Desktop. Once I start the sharing process, just like in any other Office application, I'll save the file to OneDrive first. So I'll do just that. I'll call it Retail Management and hit Confirm. Now that I've saved it, the other thing I can do is go ahead and share it with you, Ben. So I'll go ahead and create a copy link using the share action. And from there, you can use whatever app you prefer to share the link with. So I like using Teams for this, so I'm going to pass it via Teams to you, Ben.
Okay, great. Here it is. Now, on my desktop, I have the Teams chat open, and there's that Power BI link you shared with me. Now, in my case, I don't have the Power BI app installed, but that's okay. Once I click the link, it takes me straight to OneDrive in the browser, which you can see by the white bar of controls at the top. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and preview the report, and I can even interact with it. I'm going to go and filter this chart down to February to show sales for that month, and I can look at other pages that are available to me as well. So I'm going to open up this product analysis page, which is looking good, and you can see it's a fully functional experience. And again, I didn't need to go to powerbi.com or use the Power BI app, even though I'm working with a PBIX file.
Right, and also in the future, you'll be able to edit the Power BI files directly inside OneDrive and SharePoint as well.
Right, and this is great news for Microsoft 365 users in particular. Of course, if you have more than just a single report that you want to share, Power BI Pro and Premium users can leverage the app's capability, where you can then group and collaborate on related content by sharing them and publishing them as an app.
Yeah, so this is a great way to share collections of Power BI content easily. Not only are we improving the experience of creating Power BI apps, but if you have different consumers of the app inside your organization, you can now use a single app and manage what each person sees with a new capability called multiple audiences. That means you don't need to create a multiple workspace by audience. You can now achieve this using a single workspace with a superset of reports and share exactly what you want tailored to each audience, all without duplicating data and reports and preserving the single source of truth. So let me show you how this works. So I have an app here with the reports and related assets that is used by our sales, finance, and leadership teams. In fact, as part of the updated experience, you can now preview the content and add links to websites directly in the app authoring experience. I'm going to click on the leadership report, which has all the key metrics that the leadership team need to track sales pipeline for the organization. Now, I only want the leadership team to be the only ones to see this and not the sales and finance teams. In the past, I've had to create separate workspaces with different reports for each group, but now it's much easier to do this within a single app. Let's head over to the new audience tab where I can create and manage audience groups within my Power BI app. You can see here that I have already defined the sales team and finance team, and can only see that the sales team can only see the sales team reports. When I head over to the finance team, I can see that the finance group can only see the finance reports. But now I would like to create one for the leadership team. So I'll create a new audience called leadership, and now I'll customize which reports are visible to this audience. So I'll keep the leadership sales pipeline and hide all the other irrelevant reports. Next, I'll share this with you as you're a member of the leadership team group and hit update. Ben, why don't you show us the experience from your side?
Okay, let's do this. Now, back in Teams, I'm going to go ahead and click on the app link, and I can only see the reports based on my access and permissions, as well as the chart that you shared and scoped to my audience group. I'm going to look at the sales team now, and I can see three reports. I see all sales team and the leadership tabs based on my permissions, since I'm a member of multiple audiences. So it's a lot easier now to manage what insights are getting shared as you collaborate internally. But how are you making easier for people to work externally?
So we've released a new capability called cross-tenant data sharing. So this lets you share data sets with external organizations like business partners and customers and vendors in an easy, quick, and secure manner. Let me start by showing you the sharing experience. So I'm in my tenant here, and I want to share a data set with an external user. As a data set owner in this case, I have the ability to control whether I can enable or disable external sharing. Once I apply that, now I'll head over to the data set Northwind Traders Manufacturing, and I'm going to hit share. Now, similar to OneDrive, I can enter an email address, so I'm going to share this data set with you as you're a member of the Northwind Traders group. I also have the options to control if you can modify, further share, or build derivative content from this data set, and can even send you an email notification. So I'm going to hit grant access, and you're ready to go, Ben.
Okay, now this is my favorite part, because now I get to play the data analyst for Northwind Traders. Now, in Power BI Desktop, I'm here in the Data Hub. Now, first you'll see there's a new tab for external data, and from here I can see all the data sets that I have access to. In fact, I'm going to go and connect to this one that you just shared with me. Now, it's going to go ahead and request a direct query connection that I'm going to go ahead and approve, and now I can see all the associated tables. So I'm going to go ahead and select everything in this case, and that'll take just a second to create a live connection to the data set. And now I can work using combined data sets of both my internal and external data to create Power BI reports the way I normally would.
And it gets even better. We've also made finding the Power BI reports that have been shared with you from external tenant much easier.
Right, because until now, even if you had access to a Power BI report from an external tenant, finding the sharing link could be difficult. And now it's all available right in powerbi.com. So here I'm in my Power BI homepage, and I can see all of my recent Power BI reports, workspaces, and datasets. Now, there's also a new tab called From External Orgs that'll show content that's been shared from other tenants that I'm a guest of. From here, I have my normal controls for filtering to see the item type I want. So there's a lot more integration with the Microsoft 365 apps and services, and the external sharing experience is really powerful. Now, for everyone watching who's looking to try all this out, what should they do?
So the good news is most of these changes are rolling out today. So the Power BI Desktop app will appear with the rest of your Microsoft 365 apps soon, depending on your selected update channel. And everything I showed you in the Power BI service is rolling out or has recently rolled out. And of course, you can find everything you need at powerbi.com.
Mohammad, thank you so much for joining us and sharing all these great Power BI updates. And thank you for joining us as well. And be sure to subscribe to Mechanics for all the latest updates, and we'll see you soon.